Now on 5, starting on the 30th of March 1997, and now after nearly 9 years, the remains of a houseboat and 2,285 episodes later, it's time to say farewell to Family Affairs.
I changed the chart. I made the mistake, not Hector.
Oh my God, what have you done?
Indeed.
Doing very well for someone his age.
No, it's not. I am. I won the lottery.
Until death, do you part?
We will.
Congratulations. Nathan, you may now kiss your bride.
Did you get a photo of that?
Sorry, do you want to do it again?
Hold on. Do you mind?
Go.
Off you go. Go on, Jace. Oh, right, all right. Now us. Come on. Here you go. Would you be a darling? Don't worry, he's idiot-proof. What happened?
What are you doing?
Well, Hector's been let off. I told them the truth. What do you mean, the truth?
George said that she gave Mrs. Lee an incorrect dose of diamorphine. She panicked when she saw Mrs. Lee dead and changed the chart. My chart.
I'm so sorry, Hector.
Forget it.
Well, you did the right thing. So what's going to happen now?
Well, I've been suspended until they make their report. Somehow, I don't think I'm going to be a nurse for much longer.
No.
A mistake's one thing, but deliberately trying to cover it up is really serious.
Well, I'm sure it won't come to that. What a week, eh? Well, we've got 9 hours until the start of the new year. Reckon that's enough time for us to get so drunk we can forget about all of this.
I should think so.
I'll get my bag.
Oh. Yeah, get it.
There's no way you're going back to work.
Your carriage. Oh, wait.
Oh, Eve, the bouquet, chuck it. Come on, chuck it. I caught it.
Babe, you don't need it. We're already married.
All right, leaving it for this long.
All right, we'll see you in the restaurant.
So, what are we drinking?
Oh, champagne, I think. Vintage, if they've got it. Mark, I'll give you a hand, won't you? Help Gary with the drinks.
OK.
Yeah. Wow. I know. Not fair, is it? All that and a 6-week rollover. And I'm not just talking lottery, girls.
Aye!
Where's Rex?
I think he just nipped out.
Perfect timing. Just when I need to speak to him.
She's just mad because he nicked her broomstick.
Oh, Hester, have you seen Katie?
She's busy. Upstairs.
So come on, tell me honestly. How do I look?
Brilliant. Yeah, you look really brilliant.
What's up?
Nothing.
Dog?
Look, Mark's guessed that you're behind the injury.
Did he have a go?
Well, it's none of his business. Now, come on, we're going to go and have a good time.
Drinks are on me tonight. Come on, let's get ready. I'm first in the shower. George, can I borrow your red hand? Oh. I found it.
You stole it.
So, she didn't need it anymore. Oh, lighten up, George. Everyone knows things in hospitals go missing. They should pay us better.
But you could have given it back. They would never have started this whole investigation. You don't care about anybody else at all, do you?
Do you have any idea how boring you get when you get all self-righteous?
You were prepared to let me and Hector lose everything just so you could keep your hands on that stupid ring. Doesn't our friendship mean anything to you?
Well, I like you, George, but you can get a bit clingy.
What?
Well, let's face it. You've been riding my coattails ever since we first met.
I have not.
Look in the mirror, George. You look like a little old woman squinting out from your moly little glasses, fawning all over Hector in the vain hope that he will notice you. He won't. You've been wasting your time with him. You should have listened to me. I've been telling you that for ages.
You feel threatened by him, don't you? You can't stand the thought of anybody else stealing your limelight.
Ridiculous.
And you want me to hang on to your coattails. Because you need someone else to make you look good. You're nothing without me, Meredith.
You're a nice idea, but wrong. You hang around with Hector if that's what you need to do. But he wouldn't notice you if you were standing stark naked in front of him. Oh, finally, the mouse roars. Do you feel better?
A bit,
because
yeah.
You might feel better, but it doesn't make you special. Nothing will. Hanging around with me is the only way that you will ever be special.
No, it's not. Being around you, Meredith, is like being sucked into some bitter, self-obsessed black hole. You're not special. You're nothing but a failure. And you know it.
How dare you?
Do us a favour, Meredith. Get lost. Why were you covering for George? I know you didn't change that chart. You wouldn't do something like that. And I'm in the mood to get drunk. Coming to the pub?
Yeah. You go ahead. There's something I've got to do first. I'm not going to the ball.
Why ever not? Right. One ruined dress. Shame. You must have 50 million other alternatives in your wardrobe.
No. No, not like this.
Well, what's so special about this one?
It's appropriate, you know, and the rest aren't.
Appropriate for what?
Cat, I'm a vicar's girlfriend. You know, I've got everything against me. I've got to at least look the part.
Look, don't be stupid. Damien likes you for who you are, not what you're wearing.
No, I'm not going. I'm not going to let him down like this. Cat, just tell him that I'm not feeling well, that I'm not turning on my phone. I just want to be left alone.
But yes...
Please, Kat, just do that for me. Make my mind up.
OK.
So, are you going to learn Spanish, then?
Well, he speaks Portuguese, actually, but, at the moment, I don't really see the point. I think you might be a little bit too young for him. Sorry.
Where have you been?
Circulating amongst the guests. Where's Katie? You haven't still got a cleaning, have you?
No, but we have a bit of a problem.
Oh, wow, you look amazing.
I don't know quite what for. I must be the best-dressed wallflower in Charnham.
Well, Duck will dance with you, won't you, Duck?
Yeah, if you're prepared to risk it.
Later, perhaps.
Let's get some champagne.
No, I'm not going to drink tonight. I want to remember everything about the start of our new year together.
Kat, if you want a drink, have one.
No, I'm serious about turning over a new leaf. I love you so much. And what happened with Tony?
Look, I really don't want to talk about it anymore.
OK, but I just want you to know that you can trust me. And I won't hurt you again, ever.
Why the hell did you do that?
Rex, you have to think carefully about this. Think about what you stand to lose.
Get in shape with double Olympic champion, Kelly Holmes.
There's no excuses to take your first steps of fitness.
Kelly Holmes' First Steps to Fitness on DVD.
I will be with you every step of the way, helping you kickstart your fitness routine.
Begin at any level.
Keep it going.
Train at your own pace and learn the techniques to build your own fitness program.
So let's get going. Feel proud of yourself.
Kelly Holmes' First Steps to Fitness on DVD now.
Excuse me.
Hi. Is this right?
Certainly is. It's an unbelievable laptop for that price.
Fujitsu Siemens Computers Emilo L7300G
with an Intel Celeron M processor 370.
Look. The hard drive?
Huge. 60 gigs.
60?
DVD with wireless connectivity. And in the PC World sale with an incredible £200 off, it's just £499.
Right. I better take one now.
Online or in store, you've got the best of both worlds. PC World.
In the wonderful DFS sale, there are double savings. Double savings for you. Double savings for them. Double savings for him. In fact, there are double savings for everyone on a huge range in the sale. 3 years free credit and a wonderful year payment free. Double savings at DFS over the New Year bank holiday. It's wonderful.
Don't miss Matalan's half-price winter sale with fantastic savings on everything from fashion to furnishings. Matalan's half-price sale, now on.
Beautiful writing is an art in itself. Discover its skills and secrets with The Art of Calligraphy, a practical magazine with nibs, inks and papers that builds week by week into the complete calligrapher's set. The Art of Calligraphy, all you need for beautiful writing. Part 1, the box and starter kit, only 99p, usual price £2.99.
There's a big sale on at Asda. Up to half price on George. Hurry before it goes.
Why is Actimel such a great way to start the day?
Wow! I feel good.
An essential part of your natural defences are in your gut. This is where the good bacteria do an important job. Actimel with L-Cassi Immunitas can help top up the good bacteria, which make life harder for the bad bacteria.
So good!
So start the day the right way. Actimel, make life harder for bad bacteria.
No sign of anyone yet?
Huh?
We did say the 18th, right? So the 18th, right?
Yeah. Lewis!
Get Dad. Get Mum.
I'm staying out for the summer.
Get Rory.
Playing games in the
get the cousins.
The
get everyone to Haven for half-price family holidays. Call free on 0800 20 30 40 to find out more. Haven, the great family get-together.
Ever considered the truth about food? In a series of amazing experiments, we'll create a genetically modified crop and explain how cooking meat made our brains bigger. Join us live for the 180th Royal Institution Christmas Lectures and discover the astonishing truth about food. Continues 7:15 tonight on 5.
Oh, poor Yasmin. I am sorry.
Oh. Well, you know what it's like when you're sick. You just want to be left alone.
OK, everybody. Please, will you make your way to the corner cafe where dinner is served. Yeah.
Wow, you look awesome.
Just took my glasses off. I'll probably be bumping into things all evening.
You and the rest of Charlem. Let me get you a drink. Yeah, you should go out tonight and get some contact lenses. You really should.
Oh, it's beautiful. And you've actually bought it. Signed and sealed. It's all mine. You haven't noticed, have you? What? Look where it is.
It's in Chigwa.
No! I know these houses. They're by the golf course. Do you remember, Gary?
Yeah, out of our range even in those days.
Well, it's lovely, but why Chigwell? Well, why not? Seems like a nice enough place, and you always talk about it like it's the promised land.
She still does.
You could always go and stay with Eileen now.
Well, wouldn't be much point, really. Why not? Not if you live next door. Sorry? See this house? It's on the left of mine.
Yeah.
It's yours.
You are?
I bought it for you, all of you.
Don't you think you ought to tell them the truth?
I promised Jasmine.
Yeah, but it seems daft to me. I mean, what a way to start a new year, both of them being miserable.
Everyone, I hope you enjoyed your dinner. Just to let you know, coffee is being served, and then dancing will be starting outside, under the stars. Thank you.
I know I prayed for a decent dance partner, but a moping vicar wasn't quite what I had in mind.
Cat.
It was in a locked trunk, Rex. Now, I would have thought that was pretty secure, wouldn't you?
Where the hell did you hang on to it in the first place?
Well, let's just call it an insurance policy, shall we? We both know what you're like when you lose your temper, and I didn't want to end up like Kathy now, did I?
What's up? Hoping your luck will change.
You'll get lost.
Oh, you've changed your tune.
Well, we all make mistakes. No wonder your wife's got a face like a bad prawn.
Oh, now I know how you got your name.
Oh, leave me alone.
No, I like a few scratches.
Get off me! Leave me alone!
Begging for it, if I remember right. Don't you ever go near my wife again.
I warned you not to get involved with that girl in the first place.
Give that to me.
No! You're not having this. I'm keeping it. You can deal with our little problem.
I'll sue you for this.
Go near her again and I'll smack you harder.
Oh, my God, what's she come as?
Not the vicar's wife, that's for sure. Sir, I'm late.
It doesn't matter. I've been really, really worried about you.
Yeah? Listen, Damien, I really, really wanted to come. I burnt a hole in my proper dress, and I didn't think I should wear something that was, you know...
So you pretended to be ill?
I just wanted you to be proud of me.
I am. I think you're wonderful.
I didn't want to embarrass you, Damien.
Look, Yasmin, I've never been with anyone like you before. But don't go changing.
I love you just the way you are.
Now, are you sure you don't want to go to that party tonight?
Quite sure.
There is going to be fireworks after midnight.
Can have our own fireworks, yeah.
Oh, God, just ignore it.
I am.
They're not going to go away, are they?
That's someone with a lump of coal. I swear I'm going to admit it. Roxanne! Roxanne! Jason, she's gone. For the foreseeable future. Listen, I can't expect the kids to go on the run from the taxman with me, but I knew you'd take care of them, sis. Like you promised. See you whenever, thanks a million, Roxanne. She's gone.
I keep thinking I'm going to wake up and it'll all be over.
Well, enjoy the good times while you can, that's what I say.
You're a really good friend.
Yeah.
You're special.
Your trunk.
Yeah.
Yeah, come on, everyone. We've got to see the fireworks. It's 2 minutes to midnight. Come on! Hey!
Roll on 2006.
Not too late, I hope.
Wedding present. Come.
Hello.
Why do you have to ruin everything for me?
I don't ruin things. You do. Always losing your temper. If I hadn't been there looking out for you, who knows where you would have ended up? Prison, you could be dead.
Things would never get out of hand with Kathy if you'd stop meddling. You poisoned her against me.
I did not.
You did. You love having the upper hand. It makes you feel powerful. You need me to need you. What do you want from me?
Rex, now stop.
I do not want you around. I want to live my own life.
What? And ruin it with a string of trophy girlfriends. I care about you, Rex. I love you. And I know what's best for you.
Shut up! Like you're snooping.
What are you gonna do with me?
Good question. Any ideas?
Too.
Or should we go back inside and have another drink?
I don't think so, Kat.
That wasn't what it looked like.
Uh-oh.
You saved me. My hero. What's wrong?
That's what you want, isn't it? Somebody you'll find. Every time you create a new drama for yourself to star in. I can't be that person, Kat. I'm sorry.
Turn the music down. Come on, everyone. It's 20 seconds to midnight.
I love you. I always will. But you're never going to be happy with what you've got. And I'll never be enough for you. Will I?
Doug.
Thank you.
Are you vicar?
Just for tonight.
Happy New Year.
Your best yet.
I'm going to miss this place.
Won't we all?
Should old acquaintance be forgot and never brought to mind? Should old acquaintance be forgot and take a old lang syne? For old lang syne, my dear, for old lang syne, we'll take a cup of kindness yet for the sake.
So there we are, farewell Family Affairs. And what about Katie? Do you think she got out from Rex alive? Well, although the show has finished, the website's going to keep on rolling, so you could discuss that in the forum. And there are chances to win things from the show too at 5.tv/familyaffairs. And a big thank you from me to the cast and crew, especially Kasia Pelker and Gary Webster, Kate Williams and the wonderful Rosie Rowell. You were fantastic. You'll be missed. Next week, comedy with Joey.
United States government just asked us to save the world. Anybody want to save?